Sometimes we are spiritually ignorant of the things that is happening around us. When God is speaking, when God is moving, when God is changing things, we sometimes fail to recognize that. And it pains me sometimes because this nation is under siege. And we as Christians just sit back and allow that siege to continue and to grow day in, day out. When are we going to wake up? When it is too late?
This is GBC Web TV, on the internet at gbcweb.tv. Welcome to Greenford Baptist Church in West London. Here you can watch inspiring biblical teaching and other excellent Christian videos. You can order the teaching video DVDs, listen to and study the audio versions of these, or download them as audio podcasts to your computer or MP3 player. Today's inspiring and biblical teaching is called Here I Am, 1 Samuel verse 3 by Timmy Awoniyi.
Good morning, my name is Rotimi Awoniyi. I'm a member of Greenford Baptist Church. I'd like to welcome you to this second part of this morning's meeting. Before we go further, I just want to read this passage from Matthew chapter 28, 18. Then Jesus said to them, Jesus came to them and said, "All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Therefore, go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything I have commanded you. And surely I am with you always, to the very end of the age." He is with us always, at all times, to the very end of the age. And as Auntie Joan said earlier on, we are in the season of Advent, which in the Christian calendar year is when we remember and commemorate the birth of Jesus Christ. And also look forward to, anticipate his second coming. We prepare for the second coming. We celebrate the birth of Jesus Christ and look forward and anticipate his coming. And as we sit down here this morning, I want us to look at what anticipate the second coming means to each and every one of us. Anticipate his second coming. More importantly, Advent season, as during all seasons, because as children of God, as Christians, being in God's presence is not just limited to one season of the year, is it? It's every day, every minute, every second of the year. It gives us the opportunity to speak of the good news. News of hope, news of peace, news of love, news of joy, and news of salvation. And it thrills me when I see people that have the confidence to be able to stand up in front of strangers they don't know, in front of people that they've never met before, and speak of the good news. And in the passage that we read earlier on, Jesus gave this great commission that we go out into the world and preach the good news to all creation. So this morning, my brothers and my sisters, I'm asking you, how do you plan to go out into the world and preach the gospel and preach the good news to all creation? And when we talk about all creation here, It's not the whole of the United Kingdom or the whole of Europe or the whole of the world. Possibly all creation in our instances means people that we come into contact with, our family, our friends, people that we work with, people that we relate with on a daily basis. That's possibly our all creation. Yeah, it is good to be able to go out into different parts of the world and give and preach the good news. God placed it on the heart of people from this nation and other nation, European nations, to go out to Africa, to Asia, and preach the good news. But today, where is our all creation? Greenford, Northolt, London, Southeast, United Kingdom. But then you may be thinking, I'm not qualified to speak the good news. Why will you think this? Why will you think that you're not qualified? My excuse, my normal excuse is, I'm frightened of speaking in front of people that I don't know. So that could be your excuse this morning. I'm shy in public. I don't like public speaking. I'm not like Steve Williams that can speak to everybody. That's my excuse. Well, that was my excuse. But what of you? What is your excuse this morning? But I want us to look at some people and see how God touched them, how God called them, and how they responded. Because if we are going to bring, if we are going to take the good news to the people out there, we need to see, we need to realize, we need to appreciate the fact that it's not everybody that God has called to speak his good news is educated, or he's got powerful gift of speaking in public, or he's been through theology college, or he's done this, or he's done that. God called all of us, every single one of us, to speak the good news. There's no exception. There is no exception. The way you act, the things you say, the things you look at, they speak a volume about you and they minister to people that you come into contact with. My Bible did not tell me that those that were Christ's disciples were without blemish. One of them was known to be a tax collector. I'm sure if the tax man comes knocking, that's one thing that I dread the most where I work. It's not because I've done anything wrong, mind you. It's not because we have fiddled the book. We have not fiddled the books. But I dislike the tax man come knocking. They disrupt everything. You understand me? It's not because I have fiddled books now. It's just because they disrupt everything. So the tax collector, and I tell you, these days tax collectors, they are refined compared to the ones in those ages ago. So we had tax collector, we had fishermen. And actually, the Bible tells me that he walked up to them and said, oh, you're casting fish. Put your net in the lake. And they said, there's nothing there. We've tried. And just do it. They did it. They had large, bountiful harvest. And Jesus said, follow me. And they went. And this morning, Maybe God has been speaking to you. Maybe God has been challenging you. Maybe God has been asking things about you. And you keep putting it off. Tomorrow, last Sunday, we sang a song, I'll do it tomorrow. And for some of us, tomorrow never comes. Because tomorrow will always be tomorrow. There will always be tomorrow. But we need to change the mantras from tomorrow to I'll do it today. I will move it today. I will be God's servant. I will be God's voice. I will be God's messenger today, not tomorrow. Jesus saw Simon and Andrew casting their nets into a lake when he called them to follow him. Matthew was a tax collector. And when we go through the Bible, we've had many, many people that you wouldn't think would be disciples of Jesus. Saul, later called Paul, was a persecutor of Christians. But God touched him. Just as I believe that he's going to touch some of us here this morning. For some of us, this Advent season is the beginning of new things in our lives. It's the beginning of new things in our lives. I want us to look at 1 Samuel chapter 3 from verse 1. The boy Samuel ministered before the Lord under Eli. In those days, the word of the Lord was rare. There were not many visions. One night, Eli's eyes were becoming so weak that he could barely see, was lying down in his usual place. The lamp of God had not yet gone out, and Samuel was lying down in the temple of the Lord, where the ark of God was. Then the Lord called Samuel. Samuel answered, "Here I am." And he ran to Eli and said, "Here I am, you called me." But Eli said, "I did not call. Go back and lie down." So he went and lay down. He went and lay down. God called. He did not recognize that it was God that was calling him. And how many times has it been that God has called you, spoken to you, and you did not recognize that voice? How many times has people spoken to you and you did not recognize that this is a message for me? Are we too busy to be still in God's presence so that he could speak to us? God's words, although spoken by men, are God's words. God called Samuel. Verse 6, again the Lord called Samuel, and Samuel got up and went to Eli and said, "Here I am, you called me." "My son," Eli said, "I did not call you. Go back and lie down." Now Samuel did not yet know the Lord. The word of the Lord had not yet been revealed to him. First of all, before we continue, I need us to appreciate some things here. When we come into Christianity, we are on fire for God. And then it burns out. And then we just take it as day-to-day thing, Sunday medicine. I remember when I was this young, I don't know if those of us from Nigeria, we used to have what we call Sunday medicine that you take every Sunday to guard against malaria. Once every Sunday you take it. And for some of us, being Christian is becoming a routine. It's just a Sunday thing. I go to church on Sunday, then Monday to Saturday, they are my time. Then I go to church again. But here, I just want to draw our attention to the fact that the first time Samuel heard that noise, the Bible says he ran to Eli. And is it like that for us? When we first became converted, we are eager, wanting to do things for God, wanting to be God's child. And as we grow older, it just becomes a normal part of life. The second time, he didn't say that. It just says, Samuel got up and went to Eli. The Lord called Samuel a third time, and Samuel got up and went to Eli and said, "Here I am, you called me." Then Eli realized that the Lord was calling the boy. So Eli told Samuel, "Go and lie down, and if he calls you, say, 'Speak, Lord, for your servant is listening.'" So Samuel went and lay down in his place. The Lord came and stood there calling as at the other times, "Samuel, Samuel." Then Samuel said, "Speak, for your servant is listening." And the Lord said to Samuel, "See, I am about to do something in Israel that will make the ears of everyone who hears of it, tingle." There are some things that I want to draw out from this passage. It seems to me that, just as some of us, that sometimes we are spiritually ignorant of the things that is happening around us. When God is speaking, when God is moving, when God is changing things, we sometimes fail to recognize that. And it pains me sometimes because this nation is under siege. And we as Christians just sit back and allow that siege to continue and to grow day in, day out. When are we going to wake up? When it is too late? Maybe because we don't really appreciate what God is doing. In Judges chapter 2, verse 10, it says, "After that whole generation, that is the generation that God brought out from Egypt into the promised land, had been gathered to their fathers, another generation grew up who knew neither the Lord nor what he had done for Israel." It seems to me that that is what we are going through in this nation at this present time. That we are not appreciative of what God has done through this nation to the rest of the world. We are not appreciative of the fact that people from this nation took the words out to other parts of the world. We sit down in our comfort chair and let our brothers, our Christian brothers and sisters, to be under siege. We need to start to move, and we need to start to move fast. If we are going to see any reversal of what is happening in this nation,
It's not an accident that we see people killing each other every day on our streets. It's not an accident that this nation has the highest teenager birth pregnancy rate in the whole of Europe. It's not an accident that more and more people are turning their back on God. And for those of us that are still in the kingdom, it is about time we wake up. We need to do something. God is speaking to us as individuals and as a church that we need to wake up and we need to start to do something and we need to start to do it fast. Samuel did not recognize that God was calling him. Just as many in this nation today, even in this area today, that God is real and God is alive. It is down to us to tune in. When you buy a new television, unless you are properly tuned, you wouldn't receive anything. We need to tune in into what God is saying. We need to tune in into what God is calling us individually to do. If we don't, who's going to do it? It's going to take a discipline to respond. Remember, Samuel went out 3 times. Before Eli said, right, when he calls again, say, Lord, I am listening. He went out 3 times thinking it was Eli that was calling. And the thing is, willing obedience is a qualification for receiving God's words. We need to be willing to obey. Even when he knew that it's Samuel, when he knew that the first time it wasn't Eli, he knew the second time it wasn't Eli, he still went the third time. So why is it that when we first become Christians, we are on fire for God, we are praying and things are happening, after a period of time, we become just... Why? We need to be willing to keep going. We need to be willing to be what he wants us to be. There will be the good time and there will be the bad time. It's not just going to be on fire every day of your life. But you need to continue to do it. The Lord came and stood forth. That is good. He did not only call the fourth time. He came and stood there. And remember, the passage said it was rare for people to hear God's words. So God was saying, I'm not just going to give you my words. I'm going to come and stand there so that you can see. And God is here present with us today, every day. God is here in your life doing things that sometimes you don't even know he's doing. The Lord came and stood forth. So I'm asking, what are the things that we need to do? And I think that listening can lead us to action. We need to spend time with God. We need to be with God. We need to talk to God. And we need to be prepared to listen to what is saying back to us. How many of us spend time to be in God's presence? I'm not asking for answers, but this is for you to chew on. How many of us spend time to read the Bible? How many of us find time to be still and let God just deal with them? Verses 1 to 7 of this passage says that it was early in the morning. Well, that's the commentary says early in the morning because the light was still burning. How much time do you spend with God? And the other thing I want to draw out is there's partnership in learning. There is partnership in learning. God could have chosen to speak to Samuel directly. You know, when you if you're speaking to a child, you speak to them and they know this person is speaking with authority. Sit down there now. And if God chooses to speak to you without mistake, you know. But in this instance, sometimes it is good to learn in partnership. God could have spoken to Samuel directly, but it is important to remember that he chose to use an alien person, that is Eli, to draw Samuel into a closer understanding of him and to enable Samuel to hear God's words. When God is ministering to us, sometimes we are uncertain. We are uncertain. But if we have people working alongside us and guiding us, they can direct us appropriately. And for those of us that have been in ministry for so many, many years, not those of us that are just starting out, for those that have been in ministry, my message to us this morning is that God will continue to use you. Don't think or don't feel that the period of your usefulness has come to an end or is coming to an end. Because there are still many people, thousands of people, that need to be guided. Just as Eli guided Samuel to hear God's words. So there's no time to think, I'm going to retire. Actually, there shouldn't be a retirement in God's kingdom. There should be refirement. And the other thing I want to draw out here, if we read from verse 9, so Eli said to Samuel, go and lie down, and if he calls you, say, speak, Lord, for your servant is listening. So Samuel went and lay down in his place. The Lord came and stood there calling as at the other times, Samuel, Samuel. Then Samuel said, speak, for your servant is listening. Do you see difference between the words that Eli said and the words that Samuel said? Lord, it is sometimes that we are not convinced what is actually happening to us? How can it be? I'm too young. I'm only 12 years old. I'm only 40 years old, and I've still got a lot of things to do. I haven't got God's time. I have still got things to do. God is not on the agenda at the moment. My take here is Samuel probably was not convinced that God was calling him. He responded by saying, "Speak, for your servant is listening." Instead of, "Lord, speak, for your servant is listening." How can God be speaking to me? I'm just a servant here. I just minister here. I'm just Timmy. How can God be speaking to me? Me, Timmy, no. My name is not David. My name is not Samuel. My name is not Steve. I'm just Timmy. How can he be speaking to me? And maybe that's what you're thinking. I'm just me. I haven't got any special talent. I can sing. I can't dance. I can preach. I can speak to people in public. I cannot do this. I cannot do that. How can God be speaking to me? But I'm telling you this morning, my brothers and sisters, God speaks to whoever he wants to speak to. It doesn't matter that you cannot sing. It doesn't matter that you cannot dance. It doesn't matter that you cannot speak in public. But when God is ready to speak to you, he's going to speak to you nevertheless. And the thing is, let's be fair. Sometimes God's words are not always easy to speak or to hear. Am I right or am I right? Because sometimes you just don't want to hear it. But when God is calling you, who are you to say, "No, it's not for me"? When God is speaking to you, who are you to say, "It's not for me"? And I want us to know this morning, we are children of God, and we are bearers of the revelation. God's revelation to this area. Just as he called Samuel, 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 he's calling you, he's calling me, Timmy, Timmy. Am I going to run away and turn back? Or am I going to say, "Lord, speak, for your servant is listening"? And I believe that the future of this nation, and indeed the future of the world, rests on Christian brothers and sisters across the world. And are we going to be doing our part in seeing that Greenford, Northolt, London, UK is rescued? Or are we still going to sit down in our comfy chair expecting that someone else is going to do it? And the things that also trips me in this passage is the transition from the old to the new. When I said to the old to the new, I'm not just talking about being old or being young or whatever, but I'm talking about new beginning. And even as we go through this season of Advent, I think this is the period, this is the time of renewal, to move from our old self into the new. Because God is going to do new things through us in this area and in this nation. A new beginning starts today, even as we remember the birth of Jesus Christ. As we prepare to celebrate the birth of Jesus Christ. Today, a new beginning starts. As Samuel took on the mantle of hearing from God, and aged, Eli became almost irrelevant to the situation because there was a new beginning, and on Samuel's shoulder rest the destiny of Israel. And on our shoulder this morning rest the destiny of Greenford, rest the destiny of Northolt. And upon the shoulders of our brothers and Christian brothers and sisters rest the destiny of this nation. And my challenge to us is, as God calls us, what's going to be our response? Is it going to be, tomorrow should do? I've said this in the past that when I was at college, the students' union, they want something from the authorities, and the send representatives, and the rector will sit there and say, don't worry, all things, with the classes like this, all things being equal, we'll provide it next month. So the students come out and say, yes, he promised that he will provide it next month. And the next month come, nothing is forthcoming. And you go back to him and say, you promised. He said, no, I did not promise. I said, all things being equal. And the fact is, things are not equal. Is that going to be your response? All things being equal, I will do what God is calling me to do. And I'm saying this morning, that is not good enough. It is not good enough. Banish the thought of all things being equal. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. I'm going to be what you want me to be. I'm going to preach the good news. I'm going to speak of the deliverance that comes from the death of Jesus Christ. I'm going to speak the gospel of salvation. I'm going to see people come to the kingdom. I'm going to dance for you, Lord. I'm going to speak on the street for you, Lord. Is that going to be our response? Samuel answered, speak, for I am listening. It is time to listen to God. It is the time to be in his presence. If we are going to have any effect on our area and on our nation. Let's pray. Father in heaven, we thank you for your words that you have given to us. And Lord, as we pray that as you've challenged us this morning, we pray, Heavenly Father, that you enable us to be people that you want us to be, people of the kingdom. People ready to speak your words. People ready to listen to you. People ready to be your ambassadors wherever you may take us. Father, we pray that even as we start this new week, we pray that it's going to be a week that we will start to see you manifested through us, Lord. Father, we thank you for your words that you have spoken. And I pray that if there are people here this morning that are still unsure, I pray in Jesus' name that you just be at work in them so that they can grow to be sure of the words that you are speaking in them and for the people around them, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
We do hope you've enjoyed and benefited from this presentation. To learn more about what the Bible teaches us and how to apply this to our everyday lives, check out our biblical teaching and other videos at gbcweb.tv. And before you go, an invitation especially for you. Why not visit us at Greenford Baptist Church on the corner of Beechwood Avenue and Ruislip Road in Greenford, West London, the United Kingdom. Our postcode is UB69UA. Our phone number is 020-8575-5034 and our TV website is gbcweb.tv. We look forward to seeing you soon.